today's fantastic tutorial, we're going to be taking a look how you can control and manipulate any color inside DaVinci Resolve. If you're new to this channel, please like and subscribe. Every like and share helps to continue making those tutorials. So before we start, I want to give a little technical information. I've shot this on the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. If you guys want to see complete video, link above in the cards. And I'm going to show you how you can manipulate any color in this image. So the first thing first, we need to convert this into Rec. 709. Let's create a new node, Alt S. And this is very necessary before you're going to do any kind of further adjustment. Rec. 709 or P3 color is a very good starting point. That way you have some information to grab from. So I'm going to label this Rec. 709, and what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna drop this a little bit, add a little bit of shadow and add a little bit of saturation. Everything in one node, everything is fine. So this is a good starting point for us. Now I'm going to create a new node, Alt S, and I'm going to convert this into parallel node, Alt P. If you guys don't know what's parallel node, I'm gonna put link in the video above. By the way, all the gear I'm using and all my computer setup, camera setup, everything, links in the description below. So now I'm gonna do this one blue, okay? And we're gonna be manipulating blue. Now there's a few ways of really doing this. Because there's nothing else blue in this picture besides the wall, I can use hue versus hue. So I'm just gonna randomly click on blue and we can see that I can change pretty much to any color I want. Just make sure that you're not obviously doing any kind of extremes, because the more extreme you're taking this color, the more difficult for computer to process this. And we can see by a little kind of a spill we have in the hair, because it's still grabbing that blue information from the back. So what you normally can do, you can do blue, kind of green, more a little lightly purple, but let's say we want to do a little green, kind of like that, little teal. We can see this adjustment blends very nicely and we don't have any artifacts going on. So that looks great. Next thing I want to do is change the color of this little dress, I guess you want to call it, to orange. So I'm going to call this one dress. Now here is where the complexity starts, because this yellow lines on the same area where the skin tones. I cannot use hue versus hue. I'm going to need to use secondaries, because we're going to get much better selection like that. So in the secondaries, I'm just going to click somewhere over here. And I'm gonna turn on highlight, that way we can see what I'm selecting. And with this little plus sign, I'm just gonna add more to my selection. Now, it's always nice when you scrub a little bit to see if the selection is fine. We can see there's a little bit noise going on here. So let's select a little bit more. Okay, like that looks okay. Let's make it a little bit. See how immediately it grabs to skin tones? So it's very important that you're not gonna grab into the skin. Okay, like that is great. Let's do clean white for better selection. And I think like that is perfect. All right, so now we have very good selection. So there's a few ways we can do. We can go back now to hue versus hue, or we can use color wheels. I prefer to do it hue versus hue. I'm gonna select again on the same spot and I'm gonna start moving this. Okay, we can see how it changes the color. So something like that is good. However, the luminosity is still relatively bright. So what I'm gonna need to do is to drop luminosity of that. I can do hue luminosity versus saturation, hue versus luminosity, or simply use curves. I'm gonna do hue versus luminosity. And again, I'm gonna select this, go down a little bit, and we can see that it's becoming a little bit darker. Now, again, you don't really want to push this too far, because the further you push this, the more stress on the actual file you put. So the output signal may start introduce some noise or artifacts. We can see here that I still have a little bit artifacts. And if I'm gonna check it out over here, we can see that I'm getting a little spill. So either fix it a little bit and see if I can correct this. Okay, like that. Make this one a little bit bigger. Okay, so something like that is fine. Add a little bit of blur. Okay, and make sure that I'm gonna squeeze a little bit like that. Okay, and maybe add a little bit denoise. Okay, so much better now. So Shift D, let's see, before and after. Before and after. So we really start getting into a nice picture. But because everything else is so vivid and contrasted now, I really need to do overall pass on this image. Otherwise, she just looks weird against all that crazy saturation. So I'm gonna do a new note, Alt S, and I'm gonna call this one Warn. And in the curves, really quick, I'm gonna select the blue channel and I'm gonna drop it just a tiny bit. That way everything blends in a little bit better. We can also add a little bit of temperature just to make sure everything nice and blended. So let's see, Control D before and after. And that's how you manipulate all the colors inside DaVinci Resolve.